Our lives are filled with words. People tend to focus on the content, but few people notice the font itself. And different designers create fonts with very different personalities. Some are serious and elegant, some are lively and fun. And typography is the cornerstone of human-machine interaction. How is Apple doing with this aspect of the system? Now everyone has made their own brand of customized fonts. What else does Apple do well? I'm not a type designer, but after I checked a lot of information, I still want to try. Share the whole cause and effect behind it with you. The story begins with the legendary typeface Helvetica, Apple from the Macintosh era. It's integrated into the system. After iPhone was born, it directly became iOS system font. Then, when I checked the information, I can't believe it. This thing was born in 1957. That was actually back then. Helvetica was released to great acclaim as a typical representative of the internationalist style. Even from today's perspective, it is also extremely modern and neutral. We have many familiar brands. All have used or have used Helvetica. That can be said. It was like the then iPhone used this font. A match made in heaven, because as a system font, a very important factor is, it can't have too much of its own personality and style, even if criticized by some. Said Helvetica was very cold, but the cold side, sometimes it's reliable, and communication efficiency. I have met many Android users, will be in the theme store, change the default font to what italics and circles, and even more stylish typography. I don't know if the audience watching my video is doing this, you can send a bullet comment to see. Anyway, I can't accept this kind of trick myself. It's not that the font itself is any good or bad, or despise the chain, no wrong font. Only inappropriate usage scenarios. Let me give you an example. I just copy a product introduction from Apple's official website. In fact, this text is not too long, but you can definitely feel it. When reading to fonts, the flower body is obviously more difficult. You can imagine, if it is an official account, read an article, what would it be like? That uses flower bodies, it does express fuller emotions, but in comparison, sans serif fonts like Helvetica, that don't have a lot of character, it is definitely more suitable to use in the system. So here's an interesting story. There's a designer, because I'm not satisfied with the current digital version of Helvetica, he found the original movable type typeface, redesigning Helvetica digitally, named Nuihas Grotesque, and it was the official press font of OnePlus, used in all domestic and foreign marketing materials. Then this set of design specifications is still on my computer. Then push the time to 2013, for a new flat design style. Apple put the system font, replaced with a slimmer Helvetica Nui Light, to enhance the overall lighter and brighter feeling of the system. Then stand now and look back. It seems that our generation, at this time, the first time I felt the influence of Apple. Although from the current perspective, Apple's go from one extreme to another, flattening everywhere. In fact, many times it increases the cost of user understanding, but in the years that followed, not just Android, all regard flattening as an important upgrade point. An industry brand that can't even be hit by 8 poles, began to bring the original with rich details, and the logo of light and shadow effects, slap flat, into simple geometric shapes and large blocks of color. At the same time, the original classic serif font changed to a more modern, sans serif, and this process of transformation, Helvetica at the vanguard of design, played a pivotal role. Just when people think, maybe Helvetica will accompany Apple, when you go very far. Just 2 years later, Apple introduced a new font, San Francisco, at WWDC 2015. Since then, SF is used as Apple system, and the logo fonts, until today. And at the time, word of mouth was polarized. Does anyone upload? Think of the world, should not be taken by Helvetica, but there are also some designers who believe that the new font is not as good as Helvetica, especially digital design. Numbers like 1478. Why is Apple taking the risk? How about changing such a classic font? Is it because the pursuit of experience closes the loop? It has become a belief at Apple. Until I made this video while watching a Helvetica documentary, and this guy said something that kind of gave me the answer.
Helvetica is heavy in the middle, so it has a certain, it needs certain space around, needs a lot of white space, it needs very carefully to be looked at the weight gradations. It has no, it needs a lot of space sideways also. Then it's very legible, but very small and very tightly done and very lightly as modern designers. It's a nightmare, it's a total nightmare.
So this picture is a very intuitive comparison. When using 60 pounds, readability of each font won't make much difference, but it gets smaller and smaller with the pounds. Helvetica's readability plummets. The letters feel like they're all stuck together. It's very hard to tell. And the reason why Apple needs to change to SF font, because the previous year, so this is 2014, Apple has released a small screen device. This product is Apple Watch. The problem of small print dyslexia needs to be solved urgently. In order to solve the problem of text readability on the watch, the first generation of Apple Watch take the lead. SF compact fonts for small screen devices. Compared to fonts on mobile phones and computers, its lettering is narrower and more compact in design. But at the same time, the space in between the letters is magnified. This guarantees, within the limited space of the watch screen, it can display more text. It's not indistinguishable. Then the following year, Apple has officially released the entire San Francisco font family. Mobile phones and computers use SF by default. Watch with SF Compact. The two are juxtaposed as two subsets of the font family. Every SF subset actually contains two parts. When the font size is under 20 pounds, they're going to use more spacing. X higher SF text fonts increase the recognition of text. And when the font size exceeds 20 pounds, they will switch to a slightly tighter SF display in pursuit of displaying more content. These switches are fully automated by Xcode. Developers don't have any extra work. The following two pictures, it's a very intuitive comparison. Look at the time part. Helvetica's figures have an overall more compact feel. It looks more comfortable. But to the app side, SF text is cleaner and clearer in comparison. The readability of the content is obviously better. But that's it. SF is the first step. It's just beginning its evolutionary journey. In the typographic industry, there was always a problem. That is, there are only a fixed number of sets of styles for each font, like bold, standard thin, and italics. Some fonts are not even complete with these few. This allows the designer to, when you want to combine different fonts, in addition to considering whether the basic glyphs can match, you have to think about that. Do they have the required style? Of course, you can adjust it manually yourself, but once the number increases, this is a huge waste of time. Therefore, the industry is calling for can font simply and quickly achieve stepless transformation, allows designers to have greater freedom of choice. In 2016, Apple, Microsoft, Google, Adobe for jointly released the Open Type 1.8 specification to support a variety of styles of stepless adjustment, such as word weight, word width, and visual font size, and so on. SF font family, these have been supported, all the properties of the infinite transformation, and will all the font styles be placed in a file. This is today's SF Pro. The file size of SF Pro has been greatly reduced. Designers don't have to switch fonts anymore. You can get all the styles, and it appears with the SF font. There is also an icon pack called SF Symbols. I'm downloading the latest version now. It contains over 5,000 icons. It can cover almost all application usage scenarios. There are even more than 500 in there. Icons for the car dashboard for the new CarPlay. So the icons are incredibly beautifully designed, unified style, and can be seamlessly matched with SF font. Then this is for the developers of the Apple app ecosystem. Saves a lot of design and time costs. This is also the Apple ecosystem. Many native third-party apps. The reason why designs are often more beautiful. In fact, Apple is changing the SF font at the same time. Chinese fonts were also changed at the same time, replaced with the current Ping font. That's the same as SF. Ping font is also entirely based on the digital age, specially designed for use on display screens, presented in optimized fonts, and when it is mixed with SF Chinese and English, consistent weight, and the thickness of the strokes, so that they can be well integrated. It can be said that Ping font is tailor-made for SF. Compared with the polarization of SF reputation abroad, the replacement of Ping font, in fact, they are all positive reviews in China. The problem that was criticized on the Chinese bold body before have made good improvements. For example, the Chinese bold itself is literally too small. The problem of reduced readability on non-retinal screens, Ping font relies on the more lenient middle workers. Bigger literal greatly improved the readability of small font size, can adapt to more and more multi-word, rummishing layouts on the iOS. What's behind these changes? It actually reflects a trend. It is the black text font design of the body. It's becoming more and more functional, tilt towards the demand for screen reading. Then everyone, in order to meet the need for readability, invariably, they are all choosing Nakamiya to be bigger, overall more relaxed literal. But also internationalization is very important when mixing different languages. Maintain a high degree of consistency in style and Chinese design itself, those unique styles and identities. It doesn't seem that important. Although this will lead to, it seems that every brand has its own font now. It's hard to tell the difference. However, for users, and that's actually a good thing, it's getting easier to understand. Simple design and reading comfort between these basic design principles found the optimal solution. And in the past 2 years in China, people are starting to pay more and more attention to the design of typefaces. Xiaomi's Mi Sans L3 extended to support more uncommon characters, and C1CJK, even multi-line support. That's all for the digitization of the Chinese world. Generated huge help. So far, after years of development, SF has been fully integrated into all aspects of Apple. It's not just a system of fonts, no, it's a visual symbol of the Apple brand. Just see iPhone ad, the little dot on the letter I. I will tell you clearly, it's San Francisco. It represents Apple's present. So that's the fonts part, and then we'll move on a little bit and talk about typography. To say on the font, SF can only be said to be a rising star, but in digital typography, it's the lifeblood of the Apple. Although Apple's advantage in the field of typographic design, it can be traced back to the Macintosh era. They also had their own line of printers at that time. Working with Adobe, built from font design to typography, all the way down to the whole ecology of printouts, Awihirostome mentioned that Yoyon, for today's Apple, I think it's very important that they have both macro HIG design guidelines. At the same time, there are also detailed practice cases in the WDC curriculum. You can find a series of page structure suitable for different scenarios, typesetting rules, and tell you how to do it hand in hand. It allows your application to present rich content. It looks beautiful. And all this stuff, as they target system changes, it's always refreshing. They used to look like this, now it looks like this. Here's another mention of the Vision Pro. When it was released at WWDC last year, all supporting relevant design documents, it's already, like button spacing, text size, the entire framework, allows developers to navigate the 3D space. You can still follow the rules you are familiar with, come and design the layout and layout of the page, allows you to put the design draft to the ground as quickly as possible. Now that's human-machine interaction. Designability is actually an engineering ability. On the other hand, I think it may be that many people ignore it, but I have a particularly sensitive part. That's a mix of Chinese and English. Careful people should be able to find out. Subtitles in our videos, when mixing Chinese and English, will add spaces between Chinese and English. Avoid them crowding together and affecting the reading experience. It's a very grueling job, actually, but I think this is the basic experience that must be achieved. When checking the information, I also found a very interesting personal blog. Yeah, this blank space in the mix is called Pandu White, meaning it splits the chaos between full width and half width characters. In effect, in the virtual document typeset by W3C Chinese, there are also clear instructions. This space should be added, and the interesting thing about that is, Liu Qin, one of the editors of this document, it's the Western Fonts series. Then I didn't miss these books for this video, that in the printing and publishing industry, the spacing between Chinese and English, in effect, it has long been a conventional norm. At the same time, Apple has always been synonymous with rigor in this regard. He can see almost anywhere, they follow these very strict typesetting guidelines. It doesn't matter if it is a billboard under the system UI or the product page of the official website. The reading experience is consistent. Then, he is even on the product page of the official website, customized a special SF font. The Chinese in this font will be reduced to 89% of its normal size. Is that so? The size between Chinese and English will be closer. When mixing, it will reduce the sense of staggering between words. It's much smoother to read, and Apple is still in the system, directly integrated with a fully automated typesetting engine. As long as you use the original Sound UI framework, the system will automatically pull the gap between Chinese and English. No need to manually add spaces. This year, the new Orange OS also talks about an intelligent typesetting engine, but after testing this ability, it can only be used in first-party applications. Three-party applications are still not supported. But here's the magic thing. There is a domestic Android app. In the app, they built a typesetting engine similar to Apple's. It turned out to be wicked. If you don't believe me, you can go and turn it over. Chat history on your phone. Put his conversations mixed with Chinese and English. Copy to other applications. See if the typography is the same. In addition, the wicked input method is still 1-0 era. There are a few functions in total. First, put between Chinese and English numbers. Automatic white space function. Just Zhang Xiaolong. It was really fun. They do have their own persistence. No matter the previous typeface development and changes, or Apple's emphasis on typography and design, behind this, in effect, you can pull out a clear spindle to represent Apple's goals in typography, and that's what I keep saying throughout the text. Reading experience. Does it read smoothly? Will it be unclear? These are the highest priorities. It is also the most basic design requirement. According to the biography of Steve Jobs, after dropping out of Reed College and a Saturday in on some class on type design, he also developed a strong interest from then on. He started paying attention to type design, obsessed with great typography. These might have been just interests and hobbies at first, but 10 years later, became the cornerstone of human-machine interaction. If he had taken these type design courses, the personal computer may never have such exquisite typography. How about design software today? Basically presented on all major platforms, and there's even more software on Windows. Everyone can make good designs. So, why are there so many designers? Choose an Apple? I think there must be mental inertia. But other than that, I think we should really value design and respect the power of design. It is also an important reason for building trust. Light a smooth rounded corner, a real-time Gaussian blur. Look at other homes. TOS is not standard until now, and Apple also has a large number of courses every year. Teach you how to design. Start with the most basic design principles. 2. The UI framework design specification. And that's what I think. Why Apple still has an advantage in design. From designer to developer, from product manager to marketing, discuss what constitutes good design. Finding the only solution is actually very difficult, but that's just the basics. The next step is to engineer the design, atomize design elements, until it can no longer be dismantled. To define specification development components, when you perform at this level in every aspect, all touch points of the brand become one. The display of the press conference, on the page of the official website, advertisements on the subway, and interfaces on mobile phones, and all of these places are extremely consistent. This will allow users to form a strong, extremely strong memory point. Apple respects design. Design and engineering, technology and humanities. When you really analyze Apple carefully, you find these things, they don't just talk.
The real goal is about serving the human beings or positively affecting the lives of the people who use the apps that you make. Now, when we talk about design, we often focus on technique and process. And while these are important considerations, they don't lead to great designs. Great designs are guided by a deeper understanding about what design is at a more fundamental, more human level. The word human is also how we express our highest and most noble qualities. When you acknowledge someone's humanity, you're recognizing their kindness, their compassion, their generosity, and goodness.